Well, good morning, TD Christian community. My name is Mr. Dykeshorn, as you probably know. Unfortunately, we still aren't able to meet all together for an assembly, but we are very thankful that we can still have an assembly and that you are watching it in your first period class today. We got lots of amazing things happening in this month's assembly, but the biggest thing that's happening and something that we've been celebrating throughout the month of February is, of course, Black History Month 2022. So hopefully you've been following along in the daily announcements and seeing some of them in some of your classes. Those stories of Black Canadians, both past and present, are stories that we're just so thankful we've been able to help amplify at our school. Going on that same theme, today's assembly is going to have some amazing features in it. And so to kick things off, I want to introduce to you Mr. Andrew Peterkin, who is our school therapist. And he's going to introduce one of his friends who will lead us in devotions today.
Hey, TD. My name is Andrew Peterkin. You're probably wondering why I'm wearing the Jesus in Therapy shirt. Well, I love Jesus, and I'm a therapist. So I'm your school therapist at the school right now. I've been doing this for around 3 years, a little bit more than that. It was actually not my intention to become a therapist. I was still trying to figure out like what I was going to be doing. Yeah, I felt like God calling me into this profession. So it wasn't something that I really figured I would do. I actually didn't know any Black male therapists at all. Even when I started, when I looked online, there was maybe like 3 other Black male therapists that I saw online. So it was never something that I really wanted to do. I think when I was younger, like a lot of Black men in my time, I'm a little bit older than you guys, but in my time, they wanted to become like football players, basketball players, or something in music, basically. And that was kind of my position as well, like when I was younger. There was one point when I was really small, I wanted to become a doctor. I didn't see a lot of Black male doctors, so I was like, maybe that's not something I could do. So I started looking more at becoming like a football player, and I played football for a time. Eventually, I realized like that wasn't really what I wanted. So I kind of switched directions, was figuring things out, went to UFT. Long story short, went to UFT, started taking a lot of English courses, history courses, learning more about like what's happened in the past, and I started writing myself. I loved poetry, I loved writing, I loved reading stories. I've always loved reading stories, so started writing poetry, writing spoken word, performing at different events, and I ended up writing my own poetry book at one point, and I published it. So it's something that actually like wrote for my wife and for God at the same time. So it was something that was, it meant a lot to me as well. I'll actually read a poem from it right now. I found you among the rushes, sweet scented like a daisy, a delicate flower. You stood out upon the plain. It seemed your beauty like the ocean vast, your love, the waves of the ocean molding this carbon rock as it pumped this reddish hue, changing its very nature, its course, filling my very being with salt that renewed this flavor. I woke up to the sound like a morning mist, the voices of angels, a praise only you were worthy of. Holy, holy, holy are you, my God. So that's something I wrote years ago, and it was just my worship to the Lord. So that's, a lot of times that was my way of connecting with my God. So that's something that I did. So now I am doing therapy. But in light of Black History Month, I just want to say I'm so excited to kind of be here and be part of this with you guys. I think there's, from my experience, and I don't know about many of yours, but from my experience, again, I didn't see a lot of Black male professionals, even Black professionals, period, where I grew up or around me. I saw Black actors, a lot of Black musicians, a lot of like hip hop artists, stuff like that. I actually had a rapper that lived in my area as well at one point before he started doing better for himself. But I didn't really know much about like Black men becoming doctors or Black men becoming lawyers or psychotherapists or anything like that. So this was a completely new journey for me. So as I've been doing this, I've been meeting a lot of other professionals who are Black and male, which has been really encouraging for me to see, even at my age. And I'm sure for many of you, it's been encouraging as well. One thing that I'd like to do right now is introduce you to one of my friends. His name's Axel Kazadi. He went to the same school that I went to. I actually met him at an event where I was doing spoken word. I had started, myself and a few others had started a spoken word group and poetry and hip hop, different forms of art to express how we feel and express our how we feel about our Lord as well. And as we did so, it brought other churches from all over the GTA together, and we'd worship together and do all these things. So it was actually really cool. And it's something I was even thinking about doing here eventually at some point. But when I was at this event, my friend, well, Axel, he came in. We started talking for a bit because he was actually doing like a rap hip hop thing with two others. He had his group. And so we started talking for a bit. And then I thought that was like the last time I would probably see him. So it wasn't until like maybe a year later that I was going to Tyndale University, where I did my master's in counseling. And as soon as I walked through, came inside, saw a few people. I saw him actually sitting on a couch, and he was just sitting by himself, just studying. And so I went to him and talked to him. And then from there, we just became like fast friends. We've kept in touch ever since. So right now he's actually a professor in theology. He's currently still doing his PhD. And he's someone who is really encouraging for myself, growing up, not seeing a lot of black professors or black teachers, black lawyers, anything. It was really encouraging for me to see someone like this, who is also trying to move forward in the profession as well. I won't say anything else. I'll let him introduce himself, and I hope you guys have a great day.
Hi, my name is Axel Kazadi, and I would like to share my story with you. I was born in Congo DR. It's a country located on the region, on the central region part of Africa. But I grew up mostly in Canada, particularly in New Brunswick. I'm a PhD student at the University of Toronto, and also I'm an assistant professor of theology and program director of theology at Kingswood University in New Brunswick. I suppose what I can share with you is this. In my final year of high school, I lost 7 of my friends in a van accident. And that incident really devastated me. And it impacted my life significantly in many ways. I struggled with depression. I struggled with the fear of death. I had existential questions about God, about reality. And I struggled with my faith too, because at that time, I mean, I wasn't really living as a Christian, even though I said, you know, to people that I was a Christian. I wasn't really living the Christian life. But nonetheless, in that really dark moment, the Christian community that I was a part of really lifted me in prayer and supported me through that dark time. And also, I remember one night praying to God. And on that night, I really clearly, I think it was the first time I clearly heard from God. And he said this to me. He said, "It is time now for you to come back to me." And when I heard that voice, it's one of those things that I struggle explaining to people, you know. But when I heard that voice, it really resonated with me. And so I repented and recommitted myself to God, but still, I mean, I had to work through some stuff. I mean, you know, I just lost 7 of my friends, and I was really depressed, and also I struggled with the fear of death, and it took 4 years to just sort all those things out and work through those issues that I had, and counseling helped me for sure. And the church as well helped me during that difficult time. Now, this is not to say that I don't struggle with the fear of death by any means. Nor does it mean that, you know, every now and then I don't struggle with depression. But nonetheless, counseling has given me the necessary tools to use to cope and deal with these issues. And so I don't know if my story, you know, resonates with you at all, and I hope in some ways it does. But if you are somebody who wrestles with, you know, depression or struggles with the fear of death or sadness or anything like that, I just want to encourage you to reach out to your counselor and reach out to someone who you can talk to about these things. And I think as Christians, we need to really be vulnerable, in a wise way, to people who we truly trust, right? Only to people you trust, right? And I think the beautiful thing about our faith and also the church is that truth shapes our relations, right? Truth shapes our relations, and it shapes the space in which we engage and communicate with other Christians. And so in that space, there's room to be vulnerable with others, and there's room to extend grace as well to others who open, you know, who open up to us, you know. And I think we shouldn't fear, or be afraid of sharing our struggles with others, people that we trust, right? And so, I mean, everyone has different personality types, and my type is, my personality type tends to bottle things in, you know? And so I really struggle with, you know, opening up with others, and God has really challenged me in that area to grow. Like, he has challenged me to grow in that area to share things that I'm struggling with others, and I feel like when I do that, there's this sense of relief that I feel, and it is as though I'm walking in truth, you know. And truth sets us free, right? Truth sets us free. Where the Spirit, you know, dwells, there's freedom and truth. And so, given that understanding, I think it's really important for us Christians to really open up. And so, yeah, I want to encourage you to reach out to someone who you trust, to really share some of the deepest things that you struggle with. And I hope all is well with you, and may the Lord bless you in this season. Thank you for listening.
Well, thank you, Mr. Peterkin, and thank you, Axel, for not only sharing your stories and your poetry and your devotions, but also just your experience of being a Black person here in Canada, or a Black person from Congo, and how that transition was like for you when you came here to Canada. And so again, thank you so much. The next thing we're going to do is watch a feature that was put together by two grade 11 girls with the help of a lot of other students in our school. But a huge thanks to Fee and Naomi for taking this project on. And what it is they are going to tell the stories or share some of the perspectives of some Black students here at our school, here at TD Christian. And so What you're gonna see was totally created by them, put together, edited, and just a great, fantastic story. And so thank you, Fee, and thank you, Naomi, for your time. And I hope you enjoy.
My name is Nevaeh Johnson, and I'm in grade 9.
My name is Ugo. I'm in grade 9.
Daniel Pierce, I'm in grade 9.
I'm Ida, and I'm in grade 9.
Israel Jai, and I'm in grade 9.
I'm Destiny, and I'm in grade 10.
I'm Rachi, I'm in grade 10.
My name's E, I'm in grade 10.
Andre Spencer, grade 10.
Hi, my name is Naomi Ullman, and I am in grade 11.
My name is Uinosa Uwaboy, and I'm in grade 11.
It's Fee, and I'm in grade 11.
My name is Jaden Nassari, and I'm in grade 11.
Abigail Ullman, and I'm in grade 12.
Camille, and I'm in grade 12.
I'm Dania, and I'm in grade 12.
My name's Nawal, I'm in grade 12.
I am Jamaican and Danish.
I'm Nigerian.
Nigeria.
Nigerian.
I'm Nigerian.
My mom is from Trinidad, and my dad's parents are from Guyana.
I'm Nigerian.
Her background is Nigerian.
I'm Jamaican, fully.
I'm Nigerian.
Nigerian.
I'm Ghanaian.
It is West Indian, like Caribbean.
Jamaican.
I am Jamaican.
I am Black, First Nations, and white.
I went to Climbridge Christian Academy. It was definitely less diverse.
I went to KCA, Comm Christian Academy. It was less, significantly less.
HHCS. I think less.
I went to Milton Christian School. I would say that it's less diverse since it was obviously a much smaller school.
Timothy Christian School. It was around the same, I'd say.
Actually, just moved to Canada, so not in Canada.
So it was more diverse than
you? Definitely.
To elementary school in Brampton called Tridic Brock, say that it was more diverse, mainly because like there were so many different races compared to TD.
I went to Timothy Christian School. Oh, it was less diverse for sure.
I went to Timothy Christian School. It was a bit more diverse than TD when I came in grade 9.
The Halton Hills Christian School, it was definitely less diverse than here.
I went to Brampton Christian School through elementary, yeah. It was a lot less diverse.
I went to Timothy Christian School, and I would say it was less diverse, like there's fewer Black people.
Timothy Christian School, like the same.
I went to Joseph A. Gibson. It was definitely a lot more. I think that's maybe because it was a public school.
I attended a French immersion school in Vaughan. It was a lot more diverse.
It was a lot different than my elementary school. There was a lot of diversity and...
It's different because there's so many white people, so less Black people.
Really, there's not that much people that's Black, I guess.
In my grade, there are not a lot of people of Black race.
I was kind of shocked. There are not a lot of like Black people.
Well, I noticed that there's a lot of white people.
It was expected that there would probably not be a lot of Black people, but I was kind of surprised when I found out there was only 2 Black girls in grade 9.
I wasn't surprised because my brother came here and I knew it was mostly white school, but I was still kind of like surprised.
Everyone's white, so not that much diversity. Mostly Dutch people, but yeah.
Kind of expected because I've been here a few times for grade 7, 8 days, so we saw some of the students, and I didn't see many people like me, so I kind of expected not to see much more when I did come.
Yeah, like at first, like I already knew it was mostly like a white school.
I think it wasn't surprising because I knew that the demographic of TD before I went here because of my siblings, but it was like a lot to adjust to.
Yes, especially with the grade 9s this year, there's more.
I've most definitely noticed an increase. When I was in grade 9, I could like probably count a handful of black students I've seen at the school. And now that I'm in grade 10, the amount of grade 9 black students that I've seen and met is much more than what it was last year.
Yes. I feel like there's a lot more black people in grade 9.
Definitely, especially in the younger grades. In my grade, I would say that it decreased a bit. Yeah, it decreased.
In my grade specifically, no, it's actually been a decrease, but in grade 9 and grade 9 has been like more diverse.
Yes, there's been like a lot more black people in like grade 9.
In grade 9, there were like some black people like here and there, but they all left now. Most of them left, so it's more white and other races than black.
When I came in grade 9, I feel like it was definitely, there's a more level of diversity than there is now. But then after maybe the first year, it kind of died down a bit.
Yes, a lot more.
It's not that bad. It's kind of different because you're outnumbered, but you get to meet a lot of new different people and you learn a lot.
I feel welcome by students and teachers.
Yeah, I feel welcome here. Yeah.
Honestly, I think it's not very different because I personally haven't experienced any like bias or anything like that, and it's just is normal. School is normal, yeah.
I don't know if it's because I'm new or because I'm black, but I kind of do feel left out in some situations. Like it's just like me against like all of them.
I don't feel any different being a black student at TD. I feel like I'm equal with everyone else.
It's pretty normal. Like, I feel I'm treated the same as everyone else, and it's pretty good here.
It's kind of like, not really left out, but like, you know that you're different from everyone else, and like, they don't really experience the same things as you do and like, see the world the same way that you do, so it's kind of like weird, but get used to it, I guess.
It's fine, I guess. I mean, there's enough of us. Well, not that many of us.
Yeah, like, for me, I would want there to be, like, more of my culture at the school, obviously, because I relate to my race more than, like, the other races. So sometimes, you know, it can get, like, not boring, but, like, I just wish that there were more of my people here, yeah.
I mean, it's kind of interesting being in a place where you're kind of, like, distanced from what you like actually know, so it's kind of interesting like being here and like just like not being like where you're 100% comfortable.
I think being a black student at TD is hard sometimes, like when there's stuff going on outside in the real world with black people, like there's not really people that can relate to me here, so it's hard to like find people to talk to. But I think overall I haven't had a bad experience because I'm black at TD.
Just a little. Because I have a lot of different hairstyles every week, people like to touch my hair.
No, not really.
What's that?
No, for the most part, a lot of my friends and things like, you know, hair and stuff like that, they'd be very respectful and just genuinely curious to know more.
Yes, I have, actually. But, you know, I don't really let them bother me because, you know, most people are oblivious to what they do. And, you know, they're just taught it from a young age and don't really notice what they're doing. I don't really, you know, call people out on it. But I've definitely experienced the large amount. People will be like, oh, you knit, and you know, like they stop right there. They don't say it. And they're like, oh, it's okay, I didn't actually say it. I'm like, you probably shouldn't do that. And you know, there are other times when students will be like, oh, you're black, you could do this and this, whatever, whatever. I try to find them relatively funny, but some of them do take it a step too far.
Tell me, like, be quiet, monkey.
When I was in grade 9, I had 2 puffs. And a girl came up to me and she started touching and petting my hair and really feeling the puff up and saying, telling me, oh, it's so nice and fluffy and puffy. And it was very uncomfortable for me.
Mostly in grade 9 and 10, like in grade 9, some guy called me a monkey, and like, and then like people were always like petting my hair and stuff, and like asking like questions about like, they have like the N-word pass or something, like.
I mean, like the few times where people like want to touch your curly hair and be like, oh, that's nice, and like, I thank you for the compliment, but like when you try to touch it, like that's another story. And I guess there was one time, it was like in a joking matter, but someone did ask me to use the, or get the N-word pass. I was very much in shock when they asked that.
Not that I can think of right now, but I probably have.
Yeah, I think the main one is just like wanting to touch my hair.
Yeah, TD does a good job of representing people of color, especially during Black History Month.
Yeah, I think so, I guess.
I don't really have an answer for that.
I definitely think that it could be a little more, but also with the amount of diversity that we have, you know, that can also be an issue.
I guess, a bit.
I'm represented pretty well, if you know, with the students that there are. There aren't many Black teachers in the school except for Mr. Hayward and the guidance counselor, indeed. But that's around it.
I don't feel like I'm represented in this school.
No, I do not feel represented in our school.
In what way?
In history classes, especially when we're learning about Canadian history. Yes, I know that the wars are important, and I'm not saying like we shouldn't learn about them. But I feel like we can learn a bit more about Black history.
Not really. Like in like the media they show, it's kind of like one race, or like in the posters around the school, it's like all like white people, which I guess is like who's been to the school before, but it's kind of not like diverse.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, we could use a few more Black-oriented events, but I mean, this month has been pretty great.
No, I don't really think we're represented that, like, much for at TD. Like, for Black History Month, yeah, we do, like, you know, little snippets of, like, what Black people went through or something that has to do with Black culture. But, like, if you look at, like, a lot of, like, billboards and, like, posters, it's mostly all the other races that you see more. And I guess that's because there's not many Black people. But, yeah, I wouldn't really say that we're represented.
I think with the videos for Black History Month and everything, that's been nice, but like otherwise, outside of February, not much.
They do a really good job, maybe just get more in depth of Black History Month and to understand what the month is really about.
Any tips for students and teachers?
Do better.
Just make sure the kids feel welcome.
I guess treat all the students the same and equally, I guess.
Just treat people equally?
Just be open-minded and curious, but like polite, yeah.
Yeah, just be more inclusive and open-minded, I guess.
Mainly towards students, just watch what you say. I've had many things said to me. I don't really get bothered by them, but I definitely know that a lot of other people would be bothered, and they should definitely watch what they say.
Talk more about Black history when it's Black History Month, because I mean history right now, we're just doing World War I, but I feel like that could wait, you know?
Yes, I think that you should know that you don't know everything, you don't know what it's like to be a Black student here, and because of that, I think you should be more respectful and ask questions, but in a respectful and polite way.
More open and being more welcoming and not treating someone different because they're like a different color, like having a bias against them.
Be nice to Black people, I guess.
Don't try and touch our hair or don't ask for the N-word pass. That's a big one.
I think maybe just like put yourself in someone else's shoes, because like you definitely don't actually know like other people's cultures, you kind of just know your own. So you kind of have to like be able to open your mind and like see the world from another person's view.
I think just listening to Black students and like understanding that like what goes on in the real world does affect them, so it's important to talk about it and to not ignore the fact that we're Black in a white space.
So once again, ladies and all of you who contributed to that video, thank you. And as we continue to work towards being a more inclusive and a more diverse school here at TD Christian, we just look forward to continuing to partner with all of our students. And we would love to find out ways that we can better support you, we can better represent you here in our school. And we really do not want to take for granted this amazing work that you've done here and also your different perspectives. So thank you again. We're now going to switch gears just slightly. Comm Tech last semester worked on some fantastic projects, and for us to see them and to introduce them, I'd love to invite Mr. Buwalda to kind of share the story behind these videos as well. Mr. Buwalda, take it away.
Hi there, it's Mr. Buwalda. I just wanted to show you a few highlights from our Comm Tech 10, 11, 12 class that happened in first semester. It's pretty difficult during the pandemic to do video. You know, you always have to worry about your masks and that you're filming things safely. But we still managed to do some good projects, and we thought we'd show you a few of them here. So let's look at a few projects. This first one is a movie trailer project. And this one was done by four grade 10 students, Sabrina DeFranco, Destiny Frazier, Olivia Loomis, and Caleb Merson. Enjoy.
What happens when shoes come alive? Will these two friends survive?
Did we lose them? I don't know.
Or will the shoes get their revenge?
So one of my favorite shots in any movie or TV show is when you see a squad of people walking down a hallway or down a street in slow motion. They have that determined look on their face. Often there's an explosion behind them that they don't even seem to turn around and notice. That's my favorite, one of my favorite shots in a movie. So naturally, I made my students have to do a video where they had to incorporate one. So this is called Grade Heist 2. And it was made by Abigail Allman, Timothy Fall, Adrian Rajante, and Trenton Tobias.
I need your help to pass the exam, and money is not a problem.
I knew you'd come to me. I already have a plan. But first, with a new team.
Who did you have in mind?
Well, first up, we have Frankie. Frankie doesn't do his work. He's too busy pickpocketing. He's perfect for this job.
Pickpocketing? What's that got to do with this?
Think bigger. Studying is out of the question now. We're running out of time. So Frankie is going to get the keys for us, and we're going to get the exam papers.
Oh yeah.
Fine. Who's next?
Mark's also failing his class. He's always too busy working to provide for his mom. He works long hours, long shifts, and the only sleep he gets is in this class. Honestly, I feel bad for him. who I'm giving this one for free.
Keep me covered. 5 minutes, all right?
He'll act as a lookout for Frankie while he's at work.
Oh. Is there anyone else?
You. We need a distraction. You're it.
Huh?
Just do what you do best.
Oh, yes, I have.
Our next project is called fast cutting, and in a fast cutting project, you have to put in tons and tons of very quick edits to try to tell your story effectively and give it a lot of energy. This next video really did a great job of this. It's one of my favorite ones that we've had in the last few years. This is done by Ethan Wong and Aaron Day.
Aren't you supposed to be in school?
Oh yeah.
I got a spare. And I forgot my backpack.
So I hope you liked that last video. You probably noticed that a few things looked a little dangerous, and this is why I really like video. It was a trick. Because you might have noticed that they crossed against the light. They actually went in and edited the lights and made them look red, even though it was a green light. So that part wasn't that unsafe. And then the next part, where the car almost hits our subject in the film, they added that car later on in post-production. There was no car there. So just those two little things just show me that students are really getting it. They're really understanding how to be safe by using post-production techniques to do that. I would say probably not jump on those light stands. Sorry, Mr. Dendrink. So now I want to show you one more project for today. This is called a montage video, so it had to include a montage of clips, sort of like a fast cutting, but maybe the pacing is a little bit different. And I really like how this one turned out. This was done by Allison Summer and Jeff Sun. So I hope you enjoyed those Comm Tech videos, but you know, you don't just have to watch them, you can actually make them. So I do hope you consider taking Comm Tech next year. Thanks for watching. Cut. Cut.
Want to see more talent than this? Come to the talent show, March 3rd.
So that's right, the talent show is coming on March 3rd, 2022. Tickets will go on sale next week. We still have room for more acts, and so if you would like to audition, please go down to the music room and sign up and get an audition form there. We've got some great music lined up. We're still looking for some other types of acts, so if you juggle, if you know dog tricks, we would love to have some fantastic talent. Maybe you're better than Caleb at basketball, we'll have to see. But yeah, please do sign up for the talent show. We're excited to have this in-person event this year. All right, the last thing I need to talk to you about today is clubs. And so clubs are returning, and our goal is for them to start not next week, but the week after. And to help us give you better club options, we had a fantastic survey that was completed by last semester's data management class. And we took all of that data and we went back to teachers, and we hopefully can offer you a whole bunch of different clubs and some of the favorites from last semester. And so what needs to happen now is you are going to see in your EDSBE messages a broadcast that contains a link to a survey. Mr. Sawchuk spent a lot of time putting the survey together, and what we need from you is for you to go through that survey, to carefully select clubs, and to tell us what you want to take. To help you in that, we've also compiled a list of descriptions of clubs, and you are encouraged to take some time and read through those descriptions to make sure that the club you're signing up for is one that you really want to do. You're also again encouraged, just like last semester, to pick clubs that are of interest to you, or maybe even things you've never done before. So make sure you do your survey. It's going to be open as soon as the assembly is over, and what we would love if this survey is done today. Okay, and then we will hassle you if you aren't done so that you're signed up for a club, but please, please take some time and sign up for your clubs. So have a great long weekend. Hope you have some great time with your family. And once again, thank you to everyone who contributed. And as we continue through February, we would love to still look for more stories and more voices that we can hear from our Black community. Again, not only from the past, the present, and the future, so that every day we can celebrate diversity here at TD Christian. All right, have a great weekend. Take care.